My name is Bill Kroth. I'm president and executive director of the Sterling Hill Mining Museum. We're a museum located in northwestern New Jersey. We're a 501c3 nonprofit educational foundation, and we're very proud of that. We have basically rescued a mine and turned it into a museum, a learning center. We are the fluorescing mineral capital of the world. No place else on the planet even comes close. So as of today, we have roughly about 360 different minerals found here. And some minerals found here are so complex, they were not found any place else on the planet.
The two museums have recently embarked on what we call the Mineral Identification Project, and that has several components. One is to identify the minerals that we have here. Many of our minerals, they are difficult to identify by sight. The i-Raman Plus has been a great aid to us in our mineral identification project thus far. I've run thousands of spectra with it, of which we've kept 500 for the database that we're developing. Along the way in developing the database, we've had some surprises measuring a mineral that we thought was one species and it turned out to be another. Some of those surprises are quite beneficial to us. We like that. That gets us into the research component right away. So we want to develop a database of Raman spectra of minerals specific to this locality so that we can better identify our minerals. That's phase one, just develop the database. Once we have the database, we can then go into our collections, our mineral collections at both museums, and pull out those minerals which we are uncertain of the identities, run the Raman spectra, and hope to get a definitive answer. So we have to have the Raman spectra as one of the means of identifying those minerals quickly, reliably, and in a non-destructive way.
We're taking advantage of what nature has given us, and we're continuing that research. Research is important, and so this research will be published, and it's nice that we could do it in-house. It's a wonderful thing where we have the equipment here, and we could identify things that we are pretty sure or not sure at all. So this gives us a whole nother facet of science here.
This is a very complicated mineral locality. So as we go through the identification process, I'm sure surprises await us. We will find almost certainly minerals that are new to this locality, minerals that are known in nature but have not been known to be here yet. We'll find some of those. There is a chance that we will find minerals new to science.
Several minerals were found new to science in the 1970s. We hope to continue that tradition. With the modern equipment, we should be able to do it, so we've started that program right now. So we're trying to become a well-rounded educational foundation, and that doesn't only include teaching. Research is an important part of that too.
Of particular benefit to us is the video microscope that's attached to the Raman system here. We have many micro minerals in this locality, and at Franklin, 3 miles to the north, is one of the things we're known for. So we have mineral crystals that are 1 millimeter across, some are a tenth of a millimeter across, some are smaller yet. With a video microscope, I can zoom in on a particular part of one of those small crystals and measure a Raman spectrum. We're hoping that our work with the Raman spectroscopy here, the i-Raman Plus, will help us revitalize interest in this mineral locality. The pace of science of any particular mineral locality is usually episodic, and it commonly depends on one or a very small group of researchers concentrating their efforts on that locality. When those researchers go on to other things, then that locality can be effectively dormant in the scientific literature for quite a while, sometimes decades. The acquisition of the i-Raman Plus will help us revitalize that by discovering many new things here that we figure are here but yet undiscovered. Now we'll start discovering them. We will identify a lot of minerals. Some of them may be new to the locality, and we'll understand our mineral assemblages a lot better. We'll have more and more publications coming out so we can increase the pace of science here. And this is our first step.